Hi, welcome. Come on in.
Hi, Leila. Thanks for having us today. How are you?
Good, thank you.
You ready for my 50 questions?
Let's go.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate your Excel knowledge?
Seven and a half.
We need to start using Excel.
In 2000, 2001,
And what is your favorite Excel function?
filter.
And the most underrated Excel function?
Some product. Wait, come with me. I'm just in the middle of making my special coffee.
What's so special about your coffee?
Well, it's coffee with water.
Okay.
Well, here's the good part. There's some turmeric in there and some pepper and cinnamon. Do you want some?
Thank you. No, maybe a bit later. What is your most used keyboard shortcut in Excel?
Control one.
And will Excel for the web replace the desktop version?
Eventually, yes, but probably not in my lifetime.
Okay. Will Office Scripts replace VBA?
Eventually, yes, as well. So, Office Scripts is getting a lot of improvements in recent months. Once it can do a lot of what VBA can do, then yeah.
But is it still worth learning VBA?
Depending on what you need to do, so there's a lot of automation you can get done with Power Query, with Power Automate, and with the new Excel functions like filter and unique source and so on. But if you need to go beyond that and you're using Excel for desktop, then yes.
Makes sense. Do you use Excel for everything or sometimes Google Sheets?
Google Sheets as well. So just the other day, we used a cool combination between Power Automate for desktop and Power Query to grab some data from different websites. And then we use the import XML function in Google Sheets to grab the source code, or some parts of the source code that we needed, and bring it over to our spreadsheet.
Wow. Will Excel become a big data tool?
It currently is. So you can import millions of rows of data into Excel, well, not into Excel, but with Power Query, and then you can analyze it in Excel.
And what is Excel's role in an increasingly AI-driven world?
The same. It's just AI is going to make everything a lot easier, faster. We get to be more productive. So we currently have some AI features in Excel, like Ideas, which got renamed to Analyze Data. And given the recent developments in AI, we're going to get more of it inside the products that we use every day.
And where will Excel be in 10 years?
If I think back to where Excel was 10 years ago, I think I was using Excel 2010, no Power Query, using weird formula combinations, really advanced ones to get simple tasks done. Given that and the recent developments we have in AI, it's probably going to be double, quadruple the developments we're going to get in 10 years.
And will Excel ever die?
Eventually, yes.
Windows or Mac?
Windows.
And why has Excel improved so much, but Windows hasn't?
Well, I think of it like this. If Excel, for example, is like a room in a house, it's much easier to renovate a room than to renovate your entire house.
That's a good analogy. What new Windows features would you like to see?
A lot of what Power Toys has, I'd love to see that as a part of Windows.
Excel or Power BI?
It depends on what you want to do.
And what Power BI features should come to Excel?
I'd love to see custom tooltips in Excel.
What is the best way for a newbie to learn Excel?
Well, I'd start off with YouTube, structured course, and then some books. So that's usually the sequence I follow when I learn something. But the most important thing is to spend at least double the time doing, so performing the task in the application, than just learning, passively learning.
That's good advice. What are the three most important things to learn in Excel for the workplace?
Power Query, pivot tables, and the new Excel functions like XLOOKUP, filter, sort, and so on.
And what is one program or coding language you want to learn? And
Python.
where do you store all your MVP awards?
At the studio.
And who is your favorite fellow Microsoft MVP?
Ooh, that's a difficult one. There are many of them. So from Oz to Jordan, Bob, Bill, Mike, Brianna, too many to name.
Fair enough. On average, how long does one of your YouTube videos take to produce?
5 days.
And do you remember everything you teach in your videos?
Definitely not. I'm thankful we have the videos.
How many YouTube subscribers will you have by the end of the year?
Hoping for 2.5 million.
What does a typical day look like for you?
Well, usually wake up at 6 a.m., get to work by 7:40, then do some work until lunch, go back, do some more work until 6 p.m., and if you're not in course creation mode, then spend time with the family.
And who do we have here, Leila?
This is Poldy, our dog. Well, he's 1 year old, but our friends call him ugly, but we think he's cute.
He certainly is cute. What time do you go to bed?
10 p.m.
Do you get recognized when you're out and about?
No, it just happened 2 times.
And what is your favorite holiday destination?
Anywhere that's warm and has a beach.
Gotta love a beach. Your favorite meal?
Bread and cheese.
Favorite beverage?
Sparkling water with lemon.
And your favorite all-time movie?
Walk the Line.
VLOOKUP, Index Match, or XLOOKUP?
XLOOKUP.
Any plans to sell Excel-related merchandise?
Well, we currently do, like this one. We have some mugs and t-shirts, phone covers.
All right. Are you ready for your keynote at the Global Summit?
I'm not, but I will be.
Which session are you looking forward to most at the summit?
Oh, there's so many of them. Okay, one that I can think of right now is the Excel Dashboards course with custom charts. That's by Karen. Then there's the Crash Course in Pivot Tables by Liam, which is going to be funny. But that one, I think, is after 10 p.m. my time, so I'd have to watch the recording on that.
What other plans do you have for 2023?
Well, we're currently redesigning the website. We're planning a new course on advanced Excel functions and hopefully a dashboards course.
And where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Oh, I'm not a fan of these type of questions, but whatever I'll be doing, I'll be teaching.
What car do you drive?
Tesla.
Your favorite month of the year?
June. That's because it's usually warm or it starts to get warm around that time, and it's my birthday month.
Do you play any musical instruments?
Thankfully, no. I'm really bad at that.
Do you have any party tricks?
Try to leave without getting noticed.
That's a good one. What's something most people don't know about you?
I'm shy.
How long have you ever gone without Excel?
I'd say 2 weeks when we were on holidays.
Okay, Leila, final question. Gym or walk in the mountains?
Gym. I like to do my workouts in controlled environments. Which actually reminds me, that's where I'm heading right now.
Okay, have a good workout, Leila.
Thank you. Thanks for being here.
Thanks, have a good day.